Hey, how's it going? Okay, so this morning or tonight, I don't know, it's 4 o'clock in the morning, whatever you want to call it. Let's go with tonight. Tonight I just want to quickly go over a few Elliott Smith songs I find are a bit underrated. And when it comes to Elliott Smith fans, usually it's either they're diehard fans or they've never heard of him. There's rarely like an in-between. So for those of you who are big fans, I understand none of his songs in the community are really considered underrated. They all get their fair amount of appreciation. That being said, I feel there's some songs of his that don't get talked about as much as some of his other bigger songs. I'm not sure why, but I just wanted to point out four songs. And with each song, I'm gonna fast forward to a clip and play a my favorite lyric from the song or my favorite part of the song, and just briefly discuss the song without going into too much detail. So the first of four songs I have, let's see, let's bust up the list here. Okay. Pictures of Me. Pictures of Me is from Either Or, and I feel it's definitely one of his most underrated songs. It's one of my favorite songs of his. It's one of my first favorite songs of his too. A lot of his songs are left sort of open to interpretation. That's because he never really discussed very much what his songs were about specifically. And he does write a lot in metaphors. So, sometimes it can be hard to decipher. But for me, I think Pictures of Me is about the media and how it falsely portrays Elliot, even though he's doing nothing wrong, like it says in a song. And he's just being himself, but everyone has this image of him just because of what the media says. So I want to fast forward 1 minute and 43 seconds into the song here. Okay. Close enough. That one lyric, "Everybody's dying just to catch the disease," is a lyric that's always really stood out to me. It's one of my favorites of his. It's just a really cool lyric. It's like, you're dying to catch the disease. It's ironic, you know? It's like, everyone's just sort of waiting for the media, waiting for them to tell them something so they can just eat it up, you know? That's how I take it anyway. So anyway, it's a real cool song. I don't know, I guess I'll go into the next one now. So song number two on my list here is Waltz Number One, and that's from the album EXO. I think it showcases some of Elliott's best harmonies with himself throughout his entire discography, and I think the lyrics are really cool too. They're pretty straightforward, and it's just a really neat song. So I'm gonna fast forward 1 minute and 5 seconds into it. Okay. Of the bass drum. know, it's just a really cool song. It's got like a dreamlike quality to it, and it's always really stood out to me. That song caught my attention long before Waltz Number 2 did, even. And if you don't know, Waltz Number 2 is one of his bigger songs. And so I think Waltz Number 1 really gets overlooked a lot. And I think in its own way, it's equally as good of a song as Waltz Number 2. And that one lyric I just showed you, going through every out I used to cop to make the repetition stop. Just, that's the lyric that always stood out to me in that song. Anyways, also a good song. Okay, so let's see. Third song from Figure 8. And Figure 8, I think, is actually one of his most underrated albums. Usually looking at album reviews for Elliott, a lot of people seem to put his self-titled Either or XO above Figure 8. For me, Figure 8 is my favorite album of Elliott Smith's. A lot of people say that it's sort of like it shies away from his original style a bit, and that the record company sort of took control of it a bit. I don't think that's true. I think this is exactly the album Elliott wanted to make, and I think it's a great album. It's a little bit heavier. It's got a lot more distorted guitar in it. His songs are a lot fuller, and it's just a really entertaining album to listen to, start through finish. And that's got some of my favorite songs on it. So anyways, the song from this album I wanted to talk about was Color Bars. So Color Bars is a really cool song. It's got a lot of like military overtones to it. And the lyrics for it are just really cool. So I'm going to fast forward to exactly 1 minute into the song.
You're just some dude with a stilted attitude that you learned from TV. You're undue, but I'll be connecting everything.
So that's my favorite part right there. The second part where he says, "You'll undo, but I'll be connecting everything." It's just a really cool lyric to me. It's always really stood out. And overall, it's a really cool song. I want to point out one other thing in this song that's pretty subtle. A lot of people might not notice it, but it's a piano scale he plays very quickly when he transitions into the outro. I'll see if I can try to find it here quickly. There it is. Right here. That piano scale he plays there really quickly is actually, it's fucking genius. It changes the entire song, that one little piano riff right there. Basically, the entire song is played in one scale, and then that scale he plays on the piano just really stands out, and it's kind of got like a dark overtone to it, and it's just a really cool way to transition into the outro. Let me play it once more, because that's fucking cool. If you listen to this, like, the instrumentals here, I mean, he's just such a talented musician. Like, it's just a really quality song. And like I was saying earlier, I think it's just underrated a bit. No one really talks about it too much. But it's one of his better ones, that's for sure. Okay, so my last song here I wanted to quickly talk about is A Passing Feeling from from a basement on a hill, which is a really great album. It's really cool. It's a really unique album of his. And A Passing Feeling is a really great song on it that, again, is often overlooked. So I'm going to fast forward to 37 seconds. That one part makes the whole song. I mean, he repeats that a couple times, I think, but the last two parts from it, took a long time to stand, took an hour to fall. I think it's just like those two little simple lyrics sort of sum up his whole career, you know? It took a long time for him to build up his career and his musical legacy. And then it's just gone in an instant, you know. It's really sad, but but really cool at the same time. This whole album really just kind of, I feel, sums up his career, and I think it was a really good album to be released after his death. This is a beautiful album, start to finish. They're all good, though. I mean, I can't pick a favorite. Figure Eight, From a Basement on a Hill. But then again, Either Or and XO are right up there too. His self-titled, and Roman Candle and New Moon, I can say safely those aren't my favorites. Those aren't in contention, but still, great albums nonetheless. Anyways, those are four very underrated Elliott Smith songs. But even then, like I was saying earlier, none of his songs are really underrated, because, you know, I feel most fans can really appreciate all of his songs. I know I do. Anyway, that's all for now. Take it easy.